योगः कर्मसु कौशलम्।
Namaskar and welcome to ARPIT, Annual Refresher Program in English Language Teaching. Friends, we are trying to update ourselves in this Annual Refresher Program in English Language Teaching. We all are very good teachers. We are very good performers in our classes. But this course will help us to update ourselves. Today, I would like to invite Professor Shabina Omar for discussion on a different module. Namaskar, Shabina ji, and welcome to the module and welcome to
Thank
ARPIT
you so
program.
Much.
Professor Shabina Omar is a dynamic academician and an educator who believes in innovation and creativity in the classroom while teaching English language and literature, which she has been doing for the last 20 years. She is a thought innovator, social change maker, youth mentor and communication mentor. She is a skill trainer as well. She has been working for the last 18 years as head department of English, Mili Al Amin College for Girls. The college is affiliated to University of Calcutta. She has served as a principal in charge of the institution for more than 15 years. She has also been previously associated as head of department of English at Alia University and has nearly 20 years of teaching experience in English language and literature. She has published numerous critical and creative writings in several national and international publications. The publications include books and journals. She was nominated for the International Visitor Program and was invited by the US Department of State to visit many American universities as a part of the International Visitor Program. A reputed academician who travels across the country to conduct hands-on training workshops for teachers in the areas of effective strategies of English language teaching, enhancement of professional competence and skill development, as well as aspects of higher education and gender issues. Professor Omar was recently invited by the Chinese consulate in Kolkata to visit the People's Republic of China in her capacity as educator and educational administrator. She believes that one should always be willing to unlearn and relearn and thus consider herself to be a lifelong scholar and learner. On 5th September 2019, that is on Teachers Day, she received an award for her contribution to teaching, educational administration and research and has also received many such felicitations in the past. It is my pleasure to welcome her again as a resource person for this ARPIT program, that is Annual Refresher Program in English Language Teaching. Ma'am, once again, I welcome you here.
Namaskar, sir. Thank you once again for giving me the opportunity to be a part of this ambitious endeavor in the field of teacher training. This pioneering effort of ARPIT by the MHRD Government of India is indeed a laudable initiative and is a true implementation of Growing Together. It is a vision that you are endorsing very well, and I consider it a matter of privilege and pride to be associated with this. And I wish you all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
For your endeavor in this field, for your superlative coordination of this refresher course in English. At the very outset, I wish to state the topic that I have chosen to present. It is entitled Language Teaching Through Literature in Indian Classrooms. And today I shall be focusing on prose. Before I start my discussion with you, I want to make two things very clear. First, that I am not presenting any research papers. I am curating and collating several valuable and authentic inputs from myriad sources and presenting them with personal and professional experience added in the field of teaching in general and English language teaching in particular. Second, I am not here to give a lecture in the traditional sense of teaching a class. I am not here to dispense nuggets of wisdom. I am simply here to disseminate ideas that I consider to be useful and effective, and I shall be presenting them concisely, precisely, and with substantiation wherever possible. I would request the takers of this course, sir, to follow these ideas, but to feel free to accept or reject them, to feel free to agree or disagree, because after all, only the teacher knows best what is implementable in the class.
Very true.
And today, we are all stakeholders of education, and we all have diverse classrooms, and most importantly, traditionally, we have all had to teach language through literature. That is one of the systems that still prevails in many parts of the country and the world.
Very true.
So this is what I have in mind when I am trying to address the topic that I have stated today.
Very true, ma'am. One of the aims and objectives of teaching literature is to develop the linguistic ability of the students.
Yes.
And to enhance their creative and critical faculties.
Yes.
Now, what comes to my mind is, how can these faculties be achieved in Indian classrooms?
Through language comprehension. That is
naturally,
you are asking.
Yes.
Sir, this is a very good question, because teaching literature can be based upon an intensive study of the language. Mm-hmm. Because to understand literature, we must know the language.
Very true.
So, teaching literature should seek to accomplish several very clear learning outcomes.
Mm-hmm.
We must enable the students to appreciate and understand the various genres of literary and non-literary writing. We must enable them to read with accurate and appropriate pronunciation, stress, intonation, pause, articulation of voice that suits the type of literature that they are reading.
Very
or
true.
The ones that are prescribed.
Very true.
We must also enable the students, sir, to understand the passage by silent reading and close analysis. This
is
very, very important.
Very true. This is very much needed and
very,
very important.
We must enable them to enrich their vocabulary. Mm-hmm. And sir, students have two kinds of vocabulary. They have active vocabulary and they have passive vocabulary.
Very true.
They must enrich the entire repertoire of vocabulary so that they understand exactly which language structures to be used.
Very true.
We must enable them to express the ideas of the literary passage orally as well as in writing through substance, summary, précis, as well as critical analysis.
Very true.
That means the stylistic features of the passage.
Mm-hmm.
We must enable them to enjoy the subtle differences of nuance and texture of the various genres of literature.
True.
For example, the elegy and the pastoral elegy in poetry, fictional prose and non-fictional prose.
Hmm.
We must also enable the students to develop their imagination and creativity, and we can do this by exposing them to a wide variety of literary forms.
Hmm.
The more literature we read, the more literature we teach, the more enhanced will be their language and linguistic skills.
Very true. You very rightly pointed out several objectives of teaching literature and how and what is to be done for the students and for developing their various skills. We have to look them at very closely, I understand. Teaching literature offers the English teachers some of the most fundamental, immediate,
yes,
active, even physical ways to engage students,
yes,
in language learning. In the process of teaching literature, what are the effective strategies for teaching language through literature? What are your ideas on that?
Now, sir, this is a very difficult question, since there is no single effective strategy applicable to all. The effective strategies for teaching language through literature can be different from classroom to classroom.
Very true.
Depending again on how familiar is your learner with the language, how proficient is the student group, and what is their level of fluency in the language, and finally, how comfortable and how flexible the teacher is.
True. How would you teach prose? Maybe I would like to say an essay by Charles Lamb, for example.
So this is a wonderful question. I'm more than happy to address this, because Charles Lamb has been in my syllabi for the last 10 years.
Good.
10, 12 years. I have had the privilege and pleasure of teaching two essays to undergraduates and postgraduates, mm-hmm. and they have been The Dream Children and The Superannuated Man.
Good.
When I start teaching Charles Lamb, and I would advise every teacher to do so,
mm-hmm.
they must start reading themselves.
Mm-hmm.
We normally do a cursory reading.
Yes.
I would request teachers to start doing a multiple reading.
Mm-hmm.
First, engage in multiple readings of the text,
mm-hmm.
so that we can understand nuances of meaning, so that we can understand the reasoning that is going to be central to learning the content.
Okay.
Should we start with history, literature, stylistics, genre?
Fine.
So once I have done my multiple readings, I walk into the class, mm-hmm. to begin usually with a historical background.
Okay.
I give them an introduction to the Romantic period. I tell them the genre of the essay from Montaigne to Charles Lamb.
Mm-hmm.
And then I talk about the non-fictional prose writers of Romanticism in England. Finally, I conclude with a focus on Lamb's work and the themes.
Okay.
Because his main theme is that his works are usually autobiographical.
Hmm.
Because when we come to the romantic essay or the personal essay, as it's called, both you and I have been students of English literature, scholars of English literature. We know, sir, that we start studying romantic non-fictional prose from the point of view of the reader, in intimate conversation with the essayist. It's
very
like true. A friend talking to another friend.
Hmm.
The scholarship of Francis Bacon is not there.
Mm-hmm.
The objectivity is not there. And this is what I try to highlight in my students.
Mm-hmm.
Nostalgia, subjectivity, pathos, the self-deprecating humor, the ironical observations, and the ruminations on life. Just as you and I
yes.
are talking.
Hmm.
This is how Lamb seems to be talking, to be having a personal
Very
conversation
true.
With his reader. So this is an aspect that I would like to stress upon the class and then leave it to their interpretation. So I always close my classes with an open discussion.
That is very interesting, I guess. I told in one more module also regarding your teaching poetry.
Yes.
That you really talked about like a class note or a lesson plan, or this is the planning of the lesson.
A how stepwise gradation.
Yes, how exactly you'll go for
and
the
sir,
class.
And sir, a stepwise gradation is important because we do not have all of us English speaking students in our class.
Very true.
So if we go step by step, we increase the levels of difficulty.
Very true.
So it's like one more step up the ladder.
Hmm.
So a little closer to the student who is a better student than the rest.
Very true.
And one step of progress more for the weak student, enabling him to become stronger.
Hmm.
So what we are doing is we are combining the didactic aim with the humanistic effort.
Very true. So, I would like to say that this will be very useful to our learners.
I hope so.
This will be very useful to our fellow teachers and
yes.
peers for making their teaching of prose very interesting in the class.
Hmm.
It is truly admirable that you are addressing non-fiction prose from such diverse perspective. I am sure that participants will find this module both interesting and informative.
Thank you, sir. I strongly believe, because as I say that I live and breathe literature,
mm-hmm.
so I strongly believe that literature is one of the surest ways of both invigorating and improving the language of the student in a heterogeneous classroom. And the rest of my module seeks to elucidate exactly these ideas with the focus on non-fictional prose.
I request you to carry on with your discussion.
Thank you, sir.